FCPX Split Screen is a mega pack with incredible capabilities. We'll show you how simple it is to use. In this video, we'll go over the category Slice to Layouts. These presets all have common controls, and we'll demonstrate how they work with this preset, DZ Center Preset 0. So this is how the title looks when you first apply it, but don't be alarmed. We'll fix this by selecting Source Media for each of these drop zones. Much better. Now let's take a look at the controls, starting from the top. OSC, or On-Screen Control Guides, if checked on, provides a helpful visual guide in the viewer. We can see which drop zone corresponds to which number while we're editing. Guide Color lets us change the color of the guides. We can make the color easier to see, for example. Overall Position lets us reposition the entire preset horizontally or vertically. 1 and 2x Offset allows us to reposition the top half of the preset horizontally. 3 and 4x Offset repositions the bottom half of the preset. And Y Offset adjusts the vertical position of the center of the preset. We can use the rotation handle to change the angle of the design. Mask X Offset Width adjusts the thickness of the vertical gap in the center. Mask Y Offset Width does the same for the horizontal gap in the center. And Mask Roundness controls the roundness of the frame corners. Now let's navigate down to the Drop Zone controls. Drop Zone Position shifts the media in the drop zones to preset areas on the screen. The Pan control lets us move the media horizontally or vertically. And Scale adjusts the size of the media in the drop zone. Before we move on to the background controls, we'll need to offset the drop zone mask to make the background gradient visible. We'll use the settings from the beginning of the video. Now that we have adjusted the mask, we'll enable the gradient background on and off control to turn on the background. Underneath that is the background gradient control. We'll create a colorful gradient for the background. Be sure to check out the link to our gradient tutorial in the description below. Blend mode determines how the graphic style will interact with the other layers. We'll set the blend mode to add.
What a difference! Next, let's look at Hue.
Hue changes the color of the background.
Amazing, right? Next is Saturation.
Saturation adjusts the intensity of the color. Value controls the brightness of the background. Lastly, Blur Amount controls how much the blur effect is applied to the gradient background.
This is definitely a fun one to play around with.
Now you know exactly what to do, and we can't wait to see the videos you make.